pulling other stories for you from all across the metro area this morning.
Those include stories out of Westland, Madison Heights, and Troy, but let's begin in South Lyon. That's where a teen is locked up, accused of making a threat against South Lyon High School. Police say 17-year-old Ryan Dubernay allegedly asked a friend through Snapchat if he wanted to reenact the Florida school shooting. That friend reportedly said no and informed investigators of the threat. Deputies conducted a search of Dubernay's home and did not find any firearms. He was arraigned on Tuesday and remains in custody. He'll be back in court on Wednesday.
Over in Troy, a gunman remains in custody after barricading himself inside of his parents' home for nearly 12 hours. It was breaking news we brought you yesterday morning. Investigators say the standoff began early Tuesday around 3 a.m. after the 33-year-old man fired more than a dozen shots out of that home. Neighbors were asked to either go to their basements and shelter in place all day or leave the area during the standoff with police escorts. The situation was resolved safely and no one was hurt.
A man with an expired medical license was arrested in Madison Heights for trying to sell prescription drugs. Police say the suspect seen here put up an ad on Craigslist saying he was a doctor who had the drugs and party favors available at a hotel. The ex-doctor, originally from Warren, was arrested on site. It was discovered he had numerous fraudulently manufactured prescriptions in his hotel room, as well as hundreds of credit card numbers.
And the list of candidates running for Michigan's 13th congressional district seat is growing. We've been waiting to hear about this one. Westland Mayor Bill Wild now officially announcing his candidacy to run against competitors that include John Conyers' son and great nephew. Of course, this is the seat formerly occupied by John Conyers. Conyers retired last year amid sexual harassment allegations. The special election primaries will be held August 7th. The general election on November 6th.